CBS4's Mike Sullivan shows us how Hoosiers are sewing up that gap, crafting some for a local hospital.
When battling a pandemic,
and I'm going to put pieces of bias tape.
It's a team effort.
They haven't told us to slow down at all.
Not when the need is so great.
I've got a friend who's a nurse who says, oh my gosh, I need this.
It is personal protective equipment known medically as PPE, or in this case, a mask.
The end pieces, they go along the sides of your face.
The Witches of the Black Hat Society in Irvington are hand-making them for Community East Hospital. Or anyone Nancy Lynch can help.
Not COVID-19 masks, but masks to replace the other masks that they're running out of.
PPE comes in two forms, N95 medical masks or barriers. The former for instances like COVID-19, the latter.
If you're nursing someone who doesn't have a virus and you don't want to either get anything.
Our whole operational model is being rethought as a result of COVID-19. So we may have enjoyed using things before more generously than we do now.
Wendy Horn is heading up PPE emergency donations for Community Health Network.
The world changes every day, but we have a very, very strong, robust supply.
This is a mess.
Staying ahead comes with standards.
You need to use certain fabrics like cotton.
It can be sterilized, washed, and is hypoallergenic.
For community, we're making three layers, and the flannel's in the center.
Pleats help the mask fit to the face.
My little nose piece here.
That's a piece of 16-gauge florist wire with curled edges.
And that will poke through your fabric.
Sacrificing much-needed safety. In Irvington, I'm Mike Sullivan, CBS 4 News.
Mike, thank you. Joanne Fabrics has free classes and materials to learn how to make those masks. We have a link to those training videos and on the CDC guidelines for masks at CBS4Indy.com. And